Hi guys, this is Rice Snow. So last time, we loaded a world map and implemented the camera function. So now we can move around the world like this. But still, we can walk through these trees and the waters. So in this video, we will implement collision detection in a program. So player won't be able to walk through solid tiles. When we created this tile class, we created this collision boolean, so it's time to use this. First, we go to this tile manager and look for a tile that we want to change it to a solid tile. For example, this wall tile should be solid, so we don't want our player character walk through this tile. So we call this collision boolean and set it true. And also this water tile, so this one too. So dot collision equal true. And tree, this one too. And if it's not a solid tile, like this glass tile, then you don't need to add anything because the collision is false as default. So you only need to add this if the tile is solid. Okay, so tile's collision setting is done. Then we decide which part of player character is solid and which part is not. So the easiest way is set the whole tile is solid, but sometimes it won't produce the best result. For example, so if the whole player tile is solid, then he hit this wall at this point and cannot move further, but maybe you want to move him a bit further, like this, something like this. And also there is another issue. If everything is solid, then it's really difficult to get through a narrow path like this, because even if player is 1 pixel to the left or something like that, collision still happens here. And so you need to place him very precisely like this to get through, and that is simply pretty stressful and bad control mechanics in my opinion. You know, like for example, like I'm hitting this tile, so let's move to the right a little bit, and I'm hitting this tile and still, you know, I cannot go further. So to avoid this kind of hassle, we set a specific area of a character as solid, not everything, like only this part is solid. Then, you know, player can get through this kind of a narrow path. And to set this kind of collision area, first open this entity we use this rectangle class. And I'm gonna name this solid area or something, and import. With this class, we can create an invisible or abstract rectangle, and we can store data such as x, y, width, and height. Also, we create a boolean called collision on, and default is false. So now go to this player class and instantiate that rectangle. So solid area equal new rectangle. Wait, what? So Oh, what is this? solid area. So yeah, sorry, solid area. And when we instantiate this rectangle, we can pass four parameters to the constructor. So x, y, width, and height. So for example, if you want to create a rectangle which is the same size as our tile, then you type like this: 0, x0, y0, and width 48, and height 48. Or you can also type like this: gp.tileSize. Either way is fine. Or we can also leave this blank and set these values one by one like this: solid area dot x equals 0, solid area dot y equals 0, solid area dot width equals 48, solid area dot height equals 48. Yeah, so either way is fine. And since we want to make this rectangle a bit smaller than player character, so we change these values a little bit. Yeah, so maybe something like this. So this gray area is not solid, and this area is solid. So this solid area starts from x8, and the width is 32, and the height is also 32, I think. So top left corner is x8 and y16. So in that case, we're gonna change this x to 8 and y to 16, and the width is 32, and height is also 32. So you can adjust these numbers and find what works best for your game. So we got this collision area for player character. So now let's create a class to check collision. Inside of this main package, create a class, and I'm gonna name this collision checker, or whatever name you want. And the first constructor, public collision checker, and we receive game panel. So game panel GP, this GP call GP, and yeah, game panel GP, and create a method public void check tile, and we receive entity here, import entity, not player but entity, because we will use this method to check not only player collision, but also monsters and NPCs collision as well. Yeah. Now go to game panel and instantiate this collision checker class somewhere around here. So collision checker, C checker or something. Call new collision checker. And pass this game panel. Okay. And now go to this player class, and we check collision inside of this update method. So after this direction if statement, first we set this collision on to the false. And then call this checkers check tile. Oh, Oh, sorry. This needs to be public. Yeah, so we're gonna call this checkTile method from here and pass this player class as an entity. Since this player class is a subclass of entity class, so the collision checker can receive player class as entity. Alright, now the main part of this video. So what we need to do is, you know, to check if player is hitting a collision solid tile or not. And to do that, first we want to know the world X and Y of player's solid area, not player's world X and Y, because collision needs to be detected based on these solid area coordinates. There are four points to be checked: the left X and right X and top Y here and bottom Y, so this point. And we can find out these four numbers like this: integer entity left world X equal entity dot world X plus entity dot solid area dot X and entity right world X equal entity dot world X plus entity dot solid area dot X plus entity dot solid area dot width, and then entity top world Y equal entity dot world Y plus entity dot solid area dot Y and entity bottom world Y equal entity dot world Y plus entity dot solid area dot Y plus entity dot solid area dot height. Then, based on these coordinates, we will find out their column and row numbers. Integer entity left column equal entity left world X. We simply, you know, divide it by tile size. Oops. Size and entity entity right call entity right world X divided by tile size. Why I hate this suggestion. Tile size and entity top row equal entity top world Y divided by tile size and entity bottom row entity bottom world Y divided by GP dot tile size. Oh, come on. Tile size. Okay. And finally, we will create two more integer variable. The one is tile num1 and the other one is tile num2. Yeah, because basically we only need to check two tiles for each direction. So if player is going up, you know, we only need to check what tiles this point, like a player's left shoulder and right shoulder are hitting. So in this case, so if player is going up like this, then this is hitting maybe this wall tile and this right shoulder hitting this glass tile. So now we're gonna create a switch statement or if statement. We're gonna check entity's direction and the case, first case is up. Oops. Okay. Case down. Left. Right. All right. So let's take care of this up first. Entity top low equal entity top world y minus entity dot speed and divided by gp dot tile size. So for example, if so player is here right now and he's trying to go up like this. What we are doing here is we kind of predict where player will be after he moved. Oops, sorry, this is not original tile size, but just tile size, sorry. So we subtract this player's speed from player's current worldwide. Or player's solid areas worldwide, to be precise. So now we know this low number, so we can find out what tile player is trying to step in. And there are possibly two tiles. So first tile num 1 equal gp.tileManager.map tile num, so we're gonna call this map tile num. This stores all the map tile information and the index is entity left call and entity top low. What map tile num? Oh, this also needs to be public. Map tile num public. Okay, and the other one is tile num 1 call b dot tile m dot map tile num. This time, so we checked this point. So this is tile 1. So now we want to check this point. Right side. So entity right call and entity this is same top blob. And so with this information we create a if statement and call this so we're gonna call this tile array this time. So this also needs to be public. So tile m dot tile, and we're gonna use this tile num 1 as index, and check if this tile is solid or not. So collision. So if this is true, and also or gp dot tile m dot tile. Tile num 2 collision equal true. If one of them or both are true, then the player is hitting a solid tile, so he cannot move this direction. So in that case, entity.collision on equal true. What is this? Local variable time now may not be interest. Oh, this is num2, not 1, sorry. So, yeah. So if these collisions are false, then we don't do anything. So just leave it. Okay, so this upcase is done. So let's go back to this player class. Yeah, so check tile collision. And if collision is false, player can move. So if collision on equal false, and switch direction and the case up and case down. And now we're gonna move this player movement line from here to here, like this. Maybe I like this format better, I think. Yeah, because you know, now we are checking collision, so player can move only when the tiles are not solid. So first we only check the direction, and based on this direction we check collision, and if collision is not happening, then we let player move, something like that. Okay, so let's check this. Alright, so let's going up. Okay, so now this tree tile is stopping the player character, but it's still only up direction, so you can still go left and down and right. So let's take care of other directions too, and I think we can copy and paste, and we only change some variables. So if player is going down, then we're gonna check not top row but bottom row. So change this to bottom row, and this is also a bottom worldwide, this time plus entity speed. And the tile will be so left and right is the same. So yeah, we're gonna change this top to bottom. Okay. And the left, so if player is going left, then we're gonna check left call, and the left call will be entity left world x minus entity speed, and the tile num 1 will be so now we're gonna check this point and this point. So entity left call, yeah, both left call, and top and bottom. And if going right, then right call, right all x, and this time right call and change this top and bottom. That's it, I think. Okay, let's check this. Okay, so right, okay, hitting the tile, going left, okay, hitting, going down and hitting the tile, and this water tile too. So collision is happening. Yep. Looks good. So this is getting more and more like a game. So we took care of collision detection. So next time we will create objects and display them on the screen so player can pick them up. Thanks for watching and until next time.